wishes to be my disciple must pick up his cross and follow me daily. But who among us has not complained to the Lord, "Lord, I have left everything for you. I do everything for you. You have my heart, you have my love. I serve you in my local church. I am devoted to my family, I am committed to my work, and yet, after all I have done for you, you have not spared my family from marital woes, financial troubles, from addiction, from conflict." Alas, discipleship does not spare us from the storms of life. Rather, Jesus assures us to be with us as we go through the storms of life. I recalled a student of mine from Rwanda. His name was Romain. After 2 semesters of being under my class in Cambridge in Massachusetts, I asked him a very delicate question. "Romain, may I find out if you lost anyone to the genocide in Rwanda? Because we were about to commemorate the 10th year of the genocide." And his one word reply flabbergasted me, because in one word he said, "Everyone." "What do you mean you lost everyone?" And he enumerated, "I lost my father and my mother to the genocide. I lost all my sisters and my brothers to the genocide. I lost all my sisters-in-law, brothers-in-law to the genocide. So with all my nephews and my nieces to the genocide. I lost my grandparents on both sides of the family to the genocide. I am the lone survivor." I could not believe my ears, because I had never met anyone who lost all his blood relatives. "How did you survive the massacre then?" "Our seminary," he says, "was located 250 miles away from the carnage. But once we received reports about the violence, we all went to our respective hometowns to look for survivors. But I found none. But I refused to accept my tragic fate. And so I borrowed a bicycle from a friend, and for 1 month, every evening in the cover of darkness, I would ride my bike to the next village. The next morning, hope to find a survivor amongst my kinsmen and women, only to discover that there were none. And after 1 month, only then did I accept my tragic fate that I am now all alone." "And what happened to you?" He says he fell into a deep depression and left the seminary. He left the seminary angry at God, angry at the world, angry at his people. But after 2 years of soul searching, he found his way back. He recovered his faith, and found his way back to the seminary, and eventually became my student. Where is he today? He is an ordained diocesan priest in Rwanda, serving the very people whose hands may have been sullied by the blood of his own family. Discipleship does not exempt us from the storms of life. But Jesus assures us, through all the storms of life, "I will be with you." Huwag kang mamangha dahil sasamahan kita. Saan ka man mapunta dahil mahalaga sa akin, "I will be with you wherever you go."
Sasama and gentlemen, the composer, Reverend Father Melodine Francis.